Hello everyone, welcome back again in the YouTube classes. This time we will use the Edpuzzle platform. So here you will get few questions during the video. So you have to attempt that questions. Okay, you will get the questions in the right hand side of the video. So you have to attempt that questions. Got it, children? So today is a new chapter, that is factors and multiples. So what do you mean by factors? I'll explain you. And what do you mean by multiples? So factor is a number which divides a number completely. Okay, when two factors multiply, it's give a product. That number is known as a factor, and the multiples means the table of the number. Got it? So in this chapter, what we are going to learn? To apply test of divisibility, okay, and to find common factor and multiples of number, to find the highest common factor, to find the least common factor, that is LCM. Okay, least common factor, that is LCM, and highest common factor, that is HCF. Okay, LCM and HCF. LCM means least common factor, and HCF means highest common factor. Least common multiples and highest common factor. Got it? Now, to differentiate between the prime and composite numbers and to learn prime factorization. Prime factorization is the use of prime numbers. Got it, children? There are two methods, that is tree method, and one is division method. We will learn in this chapter. So let's start with the topic test of divisibility. Very easy to find out that whether the number is divisible by both 2 and 3. How? Because we know that if the last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 or 8, that means that number is divisible by 2. That means you just see the first last digit. Yes, this is divisible by 2. Now we need to check whether this number is divisible by 3 or not. So what we have to do? We have to add this number. So 1 plus 8 plus 3 plus 4 plus 2. How much? 1 plus 8 is 9. 9 plus 3 is 12. 12 plus 3 is 16, 16 plus 2 is 18. This 18 is divisible by 3. That means this number is divisible by 6, because it is divisible by both 2 and 3. Now see here. Now check this number. So the last digit is 6. That means it is divisible by 2. Okay, no problem. Now we will check that this number is whether divisible by 3 or not. So let's find out the sum. So what is the number? 1 plus 8 plus 3 plus 4 plus 6. So 8 plus 1, 9. 9 plus 3, 12. 12 plus 4, 16. 16 plus 6 is 22. So 22 is not divisible by 3. That means this number is not divisible by 6. Got it? This number can be divisible by 2, but not by 3. So it is not divisible by 6. Got it? Now, a number is divisible by 8. If the number formed by the last three digit we need to check is divisible by 8, then only we can say that 617,168 is divisible by 8. We need to find out that the last three digit is divisible by 8 or not. If it is divisible by 8, then we can say that yes, it is divisible by 8 also. Now, same here, like 3, we need to find out the sum. By 9, we need to find out the sum of the number. And if the sum is divisible by 9, that means the number is divisible by 9. Got it? And by 10, if the last digit is 0, that means it is divisible by 10. Otherwise, not. See. Only we need to check the last digit is 0 or not. If it is 0, then we can say that yes, this number is divisible by 10. Got it, children? Okay. Now, let's see few examples. So, check the divisibility of 1,58,421 and 1,58,423 by 3. So what is the process? What is the rule? So first we need to add the number. So when we are adding this number, what we got? 21. So 21 is divisible by 3. That means the number is divisible by 3. So which number? 1,58,421 is divisible by 3. Got it? Now this number we will add. So this is, the sum is 23. So as 23 is not divisible by 3, the number is not divisible by 3. That's all. Just we need to check the sum. If the sum is divisible by 3, that means the number is also divisible by 3. Got it? Now, is 18,342 is divisible by 6? So what is the process? What is the rule? First we need to check that this number is whether divisible by 2 or not. So yes, it is divisible by 2. So here it is divisible by 2 because the last digit is 2. Now check the divisibility of divisible by 3. So just we will add this number. So we got 18. So 18 is divisible by 3. That means this number is divisible by 6 also, because the sum of the digit is divisible by 8, which is divisible by 3. So the number is divisible by both 2 and 3. So 18,342 is divisible by 6. Got it? Now let's do our exercise. Okay, so what we have to do here? Circle the number divisible by the number given in the first column, and one has been done for you. So number A, divisible by 2, we need to circle. If the number is divisible by 2, we need to circle. So just see the last digit. Yes, it is divisible by 2. This is not, so this is not circle. Here 5, no. Yes, this 6 is circle. Yes, this 0 is circle, because what we have to see, whether in the last digit there is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 is there or not. If these numbers are there in the last digit, that means it is divisible by 2. Got it? Clear? Now let's do it by 3. So what we have to do, we have to add this number. So 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 5 is 8, 8 plus 6 is 14, 14 plus 8 is 22, 22 plus 2 is 24. So 24 is divisible by 2. That means this number is also divisible by 3. Got it, children? So now here, 6 plus 1 is 7, 7 plus 4 is 11, 11 plus 2 is 13, 13 plus 5 is 18, and 18 plus 0 is 18. So 18 is divisible by 3. 6, 3 is 18. That means this number is also divisible by 3. Got it? Now, 1 plus 7 is 8, 8 plus 9 is 17, 17 plus 2 is how much? 19, 19 plus 3 is 22, 22 plus 4 is 26. So 26 is not divisible by 3. That means this number is not divisible by 3. Okay, now, so we will not circle this number because this is not divisible by 3. So again here, 5 plus 3 plus 5 plus 3 is 8, 8 plus 4 is 12, 12 plus 8 is 20, 20 plus 0 is 20, 20 plus 5 is 25. So 25 is also not divisible by 3. That means this number is not divisible by 3. Got it? Now, 7 plus 9 is 16, 16 plus 5 is 21, 21 plus 1 is 22, 22 plus 4 is 26, 26 plus 3 is 29. So 29 is also not divisible by 3. Got it? So we will not circle this number. Got it? Now, divisible by 4. So we need to check the last two digits. So you just underline it. Okay, just underline it, last two digit. Okay, so 3, 4 is 12. This number is divisible by 12. It's divisible by 4. That means this number is divisible by 4 also. 4, 9 is 36. Yes, this number is divisible by 4. That means circle it. So 35 is not divisible by 4, so we will not circle this number. 0, 4 is divisible by 4, so we will circle got it? 32 is also divisible by 4, so we will circle this. Got it? Very easy. Now by 5, what is the rule? Just we need to check the last digit whether it is 0 or 5. So this is 0, so let's circle it. This is 6, so we will not circle. This is 5, yes, we will circle this one. This is 0, yes, we can circle. This is 4, so we will not circle this because this is not divisible by 5. Got it? Now, divisible by 6. So just you first check the last digit. This is 7. 7 is not divisible by 2. So just left it. We will not circle because we need to find out that whether the number is divisible by both 2 and 3. So this number is not divisible by 2. So this is divisible by 2. So let's add it number so that we need to find out that the sum of the number is divisible by 3 or not. So 5 plus 7 is 12, 12 plus 4 is 16, 16 plus 3 is 19, 19 plus 2 is 21. So 21 is divisible by 3 and it is also divisible by 2. So that means it is divisible by 3, 6. Got it? Now here 6 is also divisible by 2. So let's find out whether the number is divisible by 3 or not. So 9 plus 2 is 11, 11 plus 7 is how much? 18, 18 plus 9 is 27, 27 plus 6 is 33. So 33 is divisible by 3. That means we will circle this number because this number is divisible by both 2 and 3. So now check here. This number is not divisible by 2. So we will not circle this. Okay. And we will not find out the sum of this number because this is not divisible by 2 also. Now, 4, this is 6. So 6 is divisible by 3. So let's find out. 4 plus 3 is 7. 7 plus 6 is 13. 13 plus 7 is 19. 19 plus 1 is 20. 20 plus 6 is 26. So this is not divisible by 3. So we will not circle. Got it? Okay. Now, 8. So what we have to find out? The last 3 digit is divisible by 8 or not. So let's do it. Let's do it. Division. So where we will do? Here. So 824. So 824 divisible by 8. So 8 ones are 8. 8. So this 2, 0, 4, 8 threes are 24. Yes, this is divisible by 8 because the last 3 digit is divisible by 8. So now we will check this number 465. 465 divisible by 8. So 8 5 ja 40. 6 will come down 65. 8 8 ja 64. No, remainder is 1. That means it is not divisible by 8. Okay, so we will not circle this. Now, So 296 is divisible by 8 or not. So 8 3 is a 24, 5 6, 7 8 is a 56. Yes, it is divisible by 8. The last 8 is divisible by 8. That means it is divisible by 4 also. Now, 444. Let's check it is divisible by 4 or not. So 444 and here we go. 8 5 is 40. This 4 will come down. 8 5 is 40. So 4 is a remainder. So no, it is not divisible by 4. Now last number is 408. That means 408. So 408. So 8 5 is 40. So this 8 will come down. 8 1 is 8. Yes, it is divisible by 8. So this number is divisible by 8. Got it? Now by 9. We will check now by 9. So what we have to do, we need to add this number. If the sum is divisible by 9, that means it is divisible by 9. So 5 plus 6 is 11, 11 plus 1 is 12, 12 plus 8 is 20, 20 plus 3 is 23. So 23 is not divisible by 9, so we will not circle. Now 4 plus 7, 11, 11 plus 9, how much? 20, 20 plus 1, 21, 21 plus 6, 27. So 27 is divisible by 9. Yes, 9 3 is 27. So we will circle. Now 6 plus 9 is 15, 15 plus 8 is 23, 23 plus 3 is 26, 26 plus 1 is 27. Yes, this is also divisible by 9. Now this one. So 9 plus 8 is how much? 17, 17 plus 7 is 24, 24 plus 24 plus 1 is 25, 25 plus 4 is 29. So 29 is not divisible by 9. So we will not circle this. Now 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 plus 5 is 11, 11 plus 7 is 18, 18 plus 9 is 27. So this is also divisible by 9. So here also 27, 27 and 27. That means it is divisible by 9. Now divisible by 10. So just we need to check the last digit. If the last digit is 0, that means it is divisible by 10. Otherwise not. So this is 8. No, this is 0. Yes, it is divisible by 10. This is 5. No, this is divisible by this also not. So in this way we will find out the number whether it is divisible by the given number or not. Got it? Now circle the even number and tick the odd number in the following numbers. Here what we have to do, you know what do you mean by even number? Even number is a number which is divisible by what? 2. Got it? Even number is a number which is divisible by, so even number which is divisible by 2 and odd number which is not divisible by 2. Now 0. 0 is neither an even number nor a odd number. 0 is a whole number. Okay, so left it 0. So 2 is a even number. Just find out. Yes, 14 is also even number. 8, yes, this is also even number. 7, this is also an even number. Yes, this is also an even number. So these are all odd numbers. Okay, these are all odd numbers. Okay, just we need to check out the number whether the last digit is divisible by 2. So 0 is also divisible by 2, 8 is also divisible by 2 and 4 is also divisible by 2. That means it, all these numbers are even number, and the number which is not divisible by 2, that numbers are what? Odd number. Got it, children? So you keep on practicing. Okay, thank you everyone.